man. That was really good. I've known Ben for quite a few years. What a great guy. His son Jacoby and I went to his first Bison football game, and Jacoby's just a great kid. So anyway, thank you all so much for being here tonight. It's great to be here at NDSU at the Alumni Center. And once again, I'm just overwhelmed by the crowd tonight. Thank you so very much. I also want to extend a special welcome to the students here from NDSU. Without your help and support back in the PSC election, we might still be teaching at NDSU. Maybe that's why you all worked so hard to get me elected. I'd also like to recognize my wife, Karen, in the back there. She's always in the back, making sure if things don't go well, she can head for the door, right? No, not at all. Together, we've been through a Marine career, our time teaching here at NDSU, and now we're honored and proud to be serving you as Public Service Commissioner. Fact of life that Karen and I have learned through our journey is that in America, anything is possible if you're willing to work hard and never give up. Who would have thought that a young man from Bottineau would enlist in the Marine Corps as a private, retire 20 years later as a major, earn a PhD, and have the opportunity to teach right here at North Dakota State? Who also would have thought that this unknown Marine would run for a statewide office in North Dakota, get endorsed by the Republican Convention, and be elected by the citizens of North Dakota to serve as your Public Service Commissioner? I am a believer of the American dream. I've had a chance to live it. I thank God every day for the opportunities I have been granted in the United States of America. We are so fortunate to be living, working, and raising our families right here in North Dakota. We are the bright spot in these challenging times. While other states and our federal government are struggling with high unemployment, mounting debt, spiraling deficits, and no growth, in North Dakota, we're doing fine. However, it's just a matter of time till the irresponsible policies emerging from D.C. choke our economy. The traditional inside the beltway method is no longer working. The D.C. dance of old needs to stop. Career bureaucrats and politicians, led by a president who has no concept of how the real world operates, are trying to shut down our fossil fuel industry, even as the Middle East is about to go up in flames. This makes no sense. Additionally, our president wants to loan Brazil $2 billion to develop their offshore oil industry while effectively shutting down our offshore drilling. This is not the way to establish energy security for our country, and it's not good for the United States. It doesn't stop with energy development. These same bureaucrats and politicians, they want to regulate dust on our family farms. The system in D.C. is definitely broken. The form of government created by our founding fathers, led by the hand of God, and preserved by the blood of patriots, is in danger of being destroyed. We have a national debt of $14 trillion, and our deficit is nearly $3 trillion. We're engaged in two wars, and our president is intervening now in a third war. Our borders are porous. So what do we do? It will take determination, hard work, a solid plan, and willingness to stand up to the politicians and bureaucrats to get our nation back on track. We cannot afford another 4 years of Mr. Obama, and we certainly cannot afford another 4 years of Harry Reid leading the Senate and waging war on our energy industry. It is my hope that the American people will return Mr. Obama to Illinois so he can spend more time on his final four selections. North Dakota can also play a significant role in making sure that Harry Reid is no longer burdened with being majority leader in the U.S. Senate. It will be a real challenge to go to the Senate and make a difference. And it will not be easy to make the hard choices that will make our system whole again. It will take a cool head, great discipline, and unwavering dedication to our country and our way of life. My friends, that describes my work in the Marine Corps, right here at North Dakota State, and on the Public Service Commission. In mid-February, I was asked why I thought I could go to D.C. and do the things that needed to be done, even though I was outnumbered by the career bureaucrats. My response was simple, but direct. Marines have always been outnumbered, and we always get the job done. Yeah. future is at stake. I have, and I will, always step forward to defend our nation. Therefore, I am formally announcing that I am a candidate for the U.S. Senate in 2020. Back to Washington and to the U.S. Senate. We need long-term policies that actually work, and we need someone who will focus on what's important to our country and our citizens. It's time to change the way we operate in D.C. That's why I want to be your next U.S. Senator. I will take the skills and experiences I have gained over the past 45 years to D.C. and concentrate on the challenges that our nation faces and make sure we solve them now and don't kick that can down the road. Since our nation's beginning, every generation has been able to have a better life than the previous generation. Americans could always say, my kids will have it better than I do. Can any one of us look at our children right now, or our grandchildren, and honestly tell them their life will be better than ours? The American dream that we are so proud of, and I've had the chance to live, is in danger of becoming nothing more than a slogan. We must ensure the American dream is there for all of us to live. That's why I want to be your next U.S. Senator. Someone once asked Willie Sutton, the famous bank robber, why he robbed banks. His answer? Because that's where the money's at. Why do I want to go to Washington in the United States Senate? Because that's where the problem's at, and that's where the solutions need to be created. The litany of problems and challenges facing our nation seems endless. As I stand here tonight, our military forces are stretched thinly around the world. Our national economy is in shambles. Our national debt is $14 trillion. Can you imagine that? Trillion dollars? If I was back at NDSU teaching right now, I'd write that number on the board. You know, 1-4-0-0-0-0. It's a huge number. We have open borders, and there seems to be no will in Washington to tackle these dangerous situations. Instead, we are told we can do nothing. We cannot stem the flood of illegal aliens threatening to bankrupt our states and only add to our national security concerns. These problems must be solved. That's why I want to be your next U.S. Senator. Bureaucracies are unresponsive to the Congress and the American people. Let's take one bureaucracy that has special significance to North Dakota and has a major impact on our economy and national security. It's the Environmental Protection Agency. Last year, I worked hard to turn back the President's cap and trade bill. Thanks to our work and the work of others in the state and nation, the bill stalled in Congress. Instead of accepting the will of the people, the President and the Reid-led Senate have now unleashed the EPA to move ahead and install their own version of cap and trade, no matter what the people want. They have got to be stopped. That's why I want to be your next U.S. Senator. President Obama has now embroiled us in another war in Libya. The cost for the first 6 days of the intervention was $550 million. That is money we do not have. We are in Iraq, Afghanistan, all throughout the world. During my time in the Marine Corps, I took part in two wars, peacekeeping operations in Bosnia, and helped evacuate two American embassies in Africa. I understand foreign policy from the ground up. I say it's time we reassess our national security interests and only respond where they are directly threatened. We cannot continue to deploy our soldiers, sailors, airmen, marine, and guardsmen. They and their families are bearing the direct burden of an out-of-control foreign and national security policy. The Senate must take an active and leading role in this effort. It will take a realistic and informed view to make sure in Washington that this effort can be led. I've been in some 30 countries around the world defending our nation and our way of life. I have the worldview that needs to be implemented in Washington and the U.S. Senate. That's why I want to be here next. It all starts with the economy, and if we're not careful, it'll end with the economy. How do we begin to get this runaway spending under control? We'll have to start with something that everyone who's been in the military, who has run a small business, or raised a family, is familiar with. It's discipline. Discipline is a key ingredient in the armed forces, businesses of all kinds, and raising a family. It's only in Washington that discipline seems to become politically incorrect. Exactly. Before we can reform our government and get our country moving again, we've got to introduce discipline into the discussions in Washington, D.C. I will be happy to make that introduction. Before we can implement needed reforms, we've got to stop spending and over-regulating. And it's going to require a healthy dose of discipline for the careerists in D.C. Once again, that's why I want to be your next U.S. Senator. I've always worked hard for whatever the good Lord gave me. This election will be no different. There will be many candidates who will seek Republican endorsement for this U.S. Senate seat. But there's only one candidate who's willing to step out on January 10th of this year and form an exploratory committee to run against Senator Ken Conrad before he decided to run for re-election. You will be told that we are the underdog in this race. Perhaps we are. You'll be told that I haven't paid my political dues. You'll be told that I can't raise enough money to win a successful race. Of course, these are the same challenges levied in 2008. I hope the campaign of 2012 turns out just the same. I only know one way to campaign. We'll be in every town, every county, every nook and every cranny of North Dakota. We'll be in 20 cities over the next few days. We'll continue to do what we've done since 2007, be all over the state, working hard. That's just what we do. While others may put their trust and confidence in Washington political experts and big money bureaucrats, I will put my trust in all of you, the American people. I have been energized by the support shown to me since we announced our exploratory committee. You can be certain that I'll make every effort to earn your vote at this convention. We will be outspent, but we will never, never be outworked. Take my word for it. We are going to be at the convention, and we are going to win. Yeah. As your new senator, I will never forget about the sacrifices so many Americans have made, past and present, that allow us to be free. I'll never forget that it's your office in D.C., not mine. I'll never forget that you sent me to D.C. to lead, not to follow the masses. And finally, I'll never forget that I work for you, the American people. America's been very, very good to me. I will be honored if elected to be your next U.S. Senator. And you have my word that I will give you my very, very best every day. Deeply in the promise and hope of America. We face many challenges, but they'll be met and they'll be overcome. President Reagan once told us, it's always America, it's always morning in America, and our best days are always ahead of us. I truly believe that with the right kind of leadership in Washington, D.C., and with your help and prayers, we can make sure that President Reagan's vision will always be there for our children and our grandchildren. Thank you so much for coming this evening. God bless you, God bless North Dakota, and God bless this great nation. Thank you.